What's up everyone, welcome back to my channel. So you're wondering whether it's worth getting the Apple Card, or you're just curious what are the perks and some cons of having an Apple Card, then keep on watching because I'm pretty sure you're gonna walk away with some valuable information before you apply, or if you already have the card, this is what you should know about the card. The experience of getting the Apple Card was quite new for me for a credit card. Usually credit card companies would just send you an envelope which you just open up and then follow the instructions and then you're done from there. But with Apple, when they ship it, they're gonna contact you, hey, we've shipped it. And then a few days later, they're gonna tell you it's on a truck and by what time it's gonna arrive. And then they're gonna reach out to you when it's time to activate. So it really felt like I ordered a high-end item, which only makes sense because it is Apple. So let's go ahead and open up the box. You're gonna see white packaging inside. That's obviously where the card is, and there's no stickers or anything like that. So let's open up the white packaging. And yes, there goes the card. First impression, you're gonna be like, this is beautiful. And it's Apple. Apple does that all the time. They'll make the most basic thing look like it's a high-end product. It could be a rock, and we're gonna think this is the best rock we've ever seen in our lives. So the packaging is kind of heavy, and that's obviously because of the card. It's made out of titanium, and you could even hear it. So again, it looks very beautiful to the eye. You're gonna see the Apple logo on the top left, your name on the bottom left, the chip, the Goldman Sachs, MasterCard, and then the gray area on the bottom is the strip. And if you're just wondering, the edges are silver and not white. Now let's talk about the perks and some potential turnoffs. First, the perks. Apple claims there are no monthly card fees, foreign fees, and even late fees, which is super rare. But no foreign fees is actually a nice benefit. So you could travel anywhere outside of the United States and those fees will be waived. Late fees are also waived. So if you're late, usually companies would charge anything like $30 or $35 or even more on late fees. But Apple says they're not going to be charging you on this. But I'm gonna say a big asterisk on this because you will see later on that might not be true. Number two is the ease of applying and no credit score impact. So if you get denied, it's not gonna impact your credit score. Your credit only will get impacted when you get approved and you accept the offer. Number three is unlimited instant daily cashback. Apple allows you to get instant cashback the same day. All the cashback you get will go directly to the Apple Cash Card. A lot of credit card companies, you have to wait till the end of the month cycle and then you get your points and then your rewards. But Apple does away with that and will give you your rewards and your points the same day. So how do you get your rewards? Well, the first one is 3% cash back, and that's on any Apple products and select merchants. If you use your Apple Card with Apple Pay, then it's 2%. Keep in mind, this is the Apple Card on your phone and not the physical titanium card. On any other purchase made with the titanium card, you get 1%, which is funny because you would think they want us using the titanium card, but actually using the titanium card gets you less rewards. So really, I feel like they made a sexy looking card that's heavy just so we could frame it, but not really use it. The fourth thing is you can adjust your monthly payment and see in real time the interest cost. And the last thing which really motivated me to get the card was Apple products are now interest free when you shop at Apple, and you'll get the 3% cash back. So for example, on my $4,500 laptop, which I am going to buy, I should be getting 3% of that, and that's about $135. $135 really doesn't sound like a lot, but it's better than nothing, as that's basically like another additional discount. It's really convenient to have it within your Apple Wallet. And if you want to make it your preferred card, just touch and hold the Apple Card and drag it to the front of all your cards, and that should be it. And what I really like about the safety features are something like even advanced fraud protection, where every time you open up the app to view the card, or on Safari, it does an auto-filled when you're purchasing something online. It'll actually restart the CVV code or as some people would know it as the 3-digit code behind their card. And you can see the titanium card does not have a number in front of it. So you could literally leave this in your car if somebody breaks in or steals your wallet. Well, they don't really get away with anything from the Apple card because there's no card numbers on it. When it comes to transactions, you could actually see where purchases were made. And in case of any support, you could literally just text support within the app. I literally tried this. I had nothing to tell them, but I just wanted to try it just cause. Another nice thing is Apple Card Family is also available, which allows you to add up to 5 people to your account, or you could even have 2 Apple Card owners, like married couples, and combine those accounts into one, which obviously means the combined credit limit would now be higher. If you have kids, anyone over 13 can be added, and you could set spending controls, manage the account, and also gain visibility on where your kids are spending their money using Apple Maps. The nice thing is they too will get their own unlimited daily cash back on their own purchases. And then if you have children over 18 under the Apple Card Family, well, they actually get to start building their own credit history with all the perks I just mentioned. Another side note, which I don't think a lot of people know, although it says family within Apple Card Family, you actually don't even have to be family members, which is allowed. So call your homies ASAP and do whatever you guys are trying to do. Okay, so let's talk about the cons. To be quite honest, I don't have much, but one of them is Apple says there's no additional fees, right? Well, it's actually not quite true. Instead of charging you, say, $35 for being late on your payment, they'll just charge you additional interest. I am not sure at the time of recording this video what that additional interest is going to be, but I could only imagine it being over 1%. So it's probably not smart to miss a payment. And then the last thing is, which I'm sure will be a big deal breaker, you can only use the Apple Card if you have an iPhone. Why is that? Because you need Apple Wallet, and in order for you to have Apple Wallet, you need to have an iPhone, which really is another way for Apple to trap people within the ecosystem. So if you do not have an Apple phone, this is going to be a problem for you. So all in all, it's actually a pretty nice card to own if you're responsible. There's always going to be mixed feelings on the internet with people just saying it's just a hype product and they're not. My main reason of getting the card was to get the zero interest financing every so and so years. I do buy new bigger products from Apple, like their laptops and their computers. So it only made sense for me to buy this and take advantage of the 0% interest, and I get 3% cash back. And also I could have 2% cash back on anything unlimited without any caps. I'm sure there are better cards than the Apple Card, but these are my reasoning. Let me know in the description below whether you are planning on applying for the card or not. If you got any value from this video, please go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next video.